face off because he was infected. And then you find out that it's all these gods who used to own the earth have come to the surface. That's mermaids, shark men, starfish people, flying piranhas that will eat you from the sky, and, what's up? I get it. Behemoth, Leviathan, you know, every Cthulhu, and they're all under the water, and you can see their eyes while you're sitting in the boat. And like, I'm on a little boat in the middle of the ocean, and there's Leviathan. Always, it never stops raining. Even after it floods.
What are you trying to find?
Family
and
roommate are two different
things.
Oh, I'm sorry. Well, we'd like
to have it. Anyway. That's the most terrifying apocalyptic scenario I can think of. Being trapped on a boat with sirens in the water who want to suck my blood, but convince me to do it with their sexy ways.
Wouldn't they all starve to death way before all that?
What?
Wouldn't they all starve to death?
Not if you eat babies. Not if you eat your dog. I mean, I'm not kidding. Like, they really go into, like, Brian Keene is a terrifying writer, and I like you guys fanboy and fangirl over things. So do I, right? So when I finished that book yesterday, I tweeted out to it, and he sent me a private message, and he was like, oh man, thanks for that. He went through a bad year last year. He caught on fire. He lost all the skin on his arm. He was helping a friend or something, and the wind blew, and they were burning debris after a flood, and his arm caught on fire, and he spent a lot of time in the hospital. And back then, I sent him a couple of messages, but this time I said something, and he replied back to me, and I told my wife, I'm like, Brian keeps talking to me on Twitter! it was pretty awesome. He seems like a really nice guy, but he is a hell of a writer. All right, so we've only got a few minutes left. I need questions from people who have not asked questions so far. I see one hand over here. You should. All right, you for sure.
What's the most interesting question you've been asked
in
the panel?
That one. The most interesting question I've ever been asked in a panel? I don't know. I've been asked horrible questions. You know, my favorite questions that I've gotten, I won't detail a particular question, but I'll tell you about a panel that I hosted that I might actually be hosting this weekend on Sunday, I'm not sure. But I hosted a panel once called Bad Advice from Eric Vale. Yeah. Is that on Sunday?
Yeah.
Show up to that. My wife told me a while back, she was like, because I kept giving my son dating advice, and every time it's bad. And at one point, she goes, you are never allowed to give him dating advice ever again. Because everything you do, like, we're in the kitchen, and I'm like, just do this, just do that. And she's like, just shut up. Just let him make his own decisions, you know? And so I told her, I said, well, fine, I'll just host a panel at a convention and give my bad advice out to everybody. And I did, and it's been fun. And and I have convinced people to break up while they're sitting together.
Fuck.
And keep in mind, it's called bad advice. You guys show up, you know you're not going to get good advice, although some of that slips in. They're like, what should I do? And she lives way over there, and I live here, and this is the only place that we can meet. And I'm like, you should probably break up, because long-distance relationships don't ever work out. And you're better saving your time for somebody who lives close enough to you right now than continuing this on for what, like the next 4 or 5 years? And both of them are like, well, I mean, do you think we should? And I'm like, I told him, I said, look, you got two options here. Never see each other, or always see each other. Never see each other is what you're doing right now. Always see each other means getting married. Dude, do you have enough money for a ring? And he's like, nope, we're broken up. And that was That was it. They didn't like me much more. Thank you. Alright, so I have time to answer this one last question.
What's your favorite barbecue restaurant?
My favorite barbecue restaurant is called Bogart's in St. Louis, Missouri.
Oh, shit. I'm from St. Louis.
Better than every barbecue I've ever had in Texas. I'm sorry, Justin.
You might have to tell me which good places to eat. Especially what she just
said. It's amazing. If you ever find yourself in St. Louis, who's from St. Louis? Yeah, right on. Okay, cool. So if you ever find yourself in St. Louis, these people know, go to Bogart's. It is unbelievable. You don't even need the sauce, but take the sauce.
It's right by the Mitchell Street called Forest Park.
And then,
King Crab's
when you're
good.
Done with that, go to the city.
And
museum.
Just chicken. That
place is awesome. And my favorite time, who knows Jason Charles Miller? No? What? Really? None of you?
I don't know who that is.
He's an anime guy. He's done a whole lot of stuff. Anyway, that's where he and I met. We spent the day. We were at a convention there, and they took us to the city museum, and he and I spent the day getting lost in the tunnels and climbing forts made out of wood and a 10-story circular slide.
Oh, yeah.
You have to climb flights, and then you slide all the way down. It's a blast.
There's a movie filmed in there.
What?
There's a movie filmed in the city museum.
What movie?
It was a really cheap, like, sci-fi movie.
Yeah.
Because I watched it the other day, and I was like, oh, my God, that's the city museum.
Oh, my God, you have to tell me what it is. All right, you find it. Okay, I have to wrap this up because they're going to yell at me if I don't. So